You tweeted on September 26th. Let me quote this and pull it up for you. The Democrats want to impeach a president trying to expose a crime, then elect a person who committed a crime. Who are you accusing of committing a crime?
Go back to repeat that. You're asking me to comment on something that was out of Twitter a month ago.
Well, it's a full tweet. Let me pull it up again. I'm going to read it to you. You tweeted on September 26th, the Democrats want to impeach a president trying to expose a crime, then elect a person who committed a crime. Sir, who are you accusing of committing a crime and what crime?
I believe at the time, you're taking that potentially out of context, but I think we were talking about Hillary Clinton and we were going down that path of the emails and how we kind of just brushed that aside, or how the last Congress did and how...
No,
you're asking me to comment on something I can't see. I'm looking into a camera. You're asking me to comment on Twitter posts from a month ago. I can't see what you're talking about.
Can I just read it to you again?
You've read it to me, and I believe we were talking about Hillary Clinton.
But here's why I think it matters. Because you're an elected member of Congress, and your words, just like my words as a journalist...
You're expecting me to remember what I tweeted a month ago and have it. You're asking the same question. You're asking me to comment on Twitter posts from a month ago. I have nothing in front of me. I'm staring into a black screen. I can't even see who I'm talking to.
So, Congressman, just one to put a button on it, and we will move on. But I think your words matter, just like mine do as a journalist. Your words matter a lot.
Absolutely.
Because you're an elected member of Congress. So they matter to every person you represent. And this is, again, what you wrote. I'm sorry you don't have it in front of you. You're welcome to pull out your phone and pull up the tweet. September 26th, quote, the Democrats want to impeach a president trying to expose a crime, comma, then elect a person who committed a crime. You're accusing someone running for president of committing a crime, and I'm asking you who that person is.
It triggered me now. We're talking about Joe Biden in that particular tweet, because at the time, we were talking about how the president was bragging about a prosecutor that he got fired in the Ukraine, and we were going down this path at the time when Joe Biden was leading in the polls. He's not anymore, but now it comes back to me, now that you've read it three times and I've run through my Twitter account in my mind, which is difficult to do. But we're talking about Joe Biden. If Joe Biden is going overseas and bragging about getting a prosecutor fired that was investigating his son, that is absolutely as much criminal. We've come to a point where a vice president, when something happens that the vice president does and then he runs for president, suddenly he's immune from any investigation or prosecution at all. That tells me that if I want to break the law, all I've got to do is run for president and you can't investigate me. That's crazy.
There are some really big holes in that argument, but let's start with the biggest one. There is zero evidence at this point that Joe Biden did anything wrong. As you know, he was among so many leaders in the West calling for Shokin to be pushed out as prosecutor. The IMF,
how do you know this?
Christine Lagarde,
how do you know this?
You read it in a leaked
report? Did you read it in a leaked report?
No, it's our reporting.
A leaked report that you haven't seen? This is from the New York Times. They're great with the leaks.
Congressman, could you just respectfully let me finish the question? Okay.
Sure.
Let me cite to you from someone in the Bush administration, okay? Not some liberal. Quote, Stephen Pfeiffer, who was a career Foreign Service officer in the Bush administration, talking about why Shokin had to go. Virtually everyone that in the U.S. government, he says that he knew at the time, quote, felt that Shokin was not doing his job and should be fired. You are saying in this tweet your words to everyone without any evidence that Joe Biden committed a crime. Where is your evidence, sir?
I'm saying that we've gone down this path where if the President of the United States says he wants corruption thrown out of our society, he wants to investigate corruption, that's suddenly an outrage, offensive thing to bring forward. Democrats on the other side are outraged that this president wants to get corruption out of our society. And so what have they done? They've started these investigations. We don't even know what's happening.
Can you help can you help me square the circle here? Because I'm having a hard time. You're upset with the process of how Democrats are conducting this inquiry. And you can come
voice
that.
Aren't you upset with the process?
That's your opinion, sir. But they're conducting an inquiry.
It's an opinion shared.
They are conducting an inquiry
by every Republican in Congress that has been shut out of this process.
Congressman, the Democrats are conducting an inquiry into whether there were high crimes here, right, by the president, whether something is impeachable. Without
Do you
an
know
inquiry,
that? Because I haven't seen anything
Twitter,
but leaks.
Without
this,
an inquiry, you
not,
said on...
This is not
without
a
Without an inquiry, sir, you said
me.
On Twitter that Joe Biden committed a crime. That's my point. Square the circle for me.
So let me... Okay, here's the circle. You're comparing a Twitter post to an impeachment inquiry that is bringing people into a skiff where members of Congress don't even know what's happening if they're not part of the 40. You're comparing a Twitter post to... An yeah. inquiry of impeachment well, that the U.S. House has not authorized. That's a stretch.
Yeah. Democrats have the right to hold this inquiry the way they are doing it now. They do.
Oh,
that's just the
I'm
fact.
Not saying I'm not saying it's,
go,
I'm not saying it's illegal
you're,
what they're doing, but the American people are outraged by this process. And the fact that the fake news media is not outraged with me is very telling.
Please don't insult the media on this network or on this show, on our show. And Congressman, you say it's just a Twitter post, but it's your words, and your words matter a lot. Thank you for being here.
I didn't
here.
Say it's just a Twitter post. Those are your words. I said you're comparing a Twitter post to an impeachment inquiry.
I apologize. I shouldn't have added the word just. Congressman Lance Gooden, thank you for being here. Jim.
Poppy, good for you to calling it out. It's a frequent talking point. Go to the fake news media. I had the experience yesterday asking direct questions of the President's Trade's advisor.
I know.
And more power to you.
I just...
And listen, it's about giving straight answers to straight questions.
I just think that words matter. And when you represent so many people in the U.S. Congress and you write that someone has committed a crime, come here with the evidence. And I'm happy to debate it with you anytime.